Hello guys, today we will be doing one fun experiment showing refraction through a rectangular glass slab. So these are the materials that we need, very easily available materials at home. First you need a glass slab. I will share the link how to find a glass slab on Amazon. It's very cheap, you get a full kit with lens, mirrors. Then we need an A3 or A4 sheet. And then a protractor. See here, I have taken a 360 degree protractor. You just need a normal 180 degree protractor that comes in your geometry box. Then very important, a scale. I have taken a 30 meter scale, 15 meter will do, and a sharp pencil. Now this is the fun part. I am taking 4 thread spools in 4 different colors. This usually in lab we use all pens, but what's the fun in all pens, isn't it? So we'll start with the experiment. First place the glass slab and then trace the outline of the glass slab. You will get a rectangle when you trace it. Right? So very carefully trace the outside or outline of the glass slab like this. Okay, done. Now remove the glass slab. Now pick any point on one side of the glass slab. Okay, somewhere near to the middle. You cannot exactly midpoint, you need somewhere near to the middle, and draw a perpendicular. Now what will this perpendicular become? Yes, this is your normal. Okay, so a line that is perpendicular to the refracting surface, that is called a normal. This is an imaginary line usually, so this will act as our normal. Now from the normal we'll measure 30 degree angle and then draw a angle, 30 degree angle like this, using a scale and protractor. When you're doing it on paper, please be careful to use a sharp pencil. Here I'm using markers. So what does this line represent? Yes, this will be our incident ray, such that angle of incidence is 30 degree. Okay, so this is the direction of incoming light. Now I'll place these two objects. One red color thread I have kept, and another is yellow one, and you have to place these two on the incident ray at some 1 centimeter distance. Okay, around 1-1.5 centimeter you can keep these two. These will act as your objects and keep the glass slab back. Fine. Now I'm looking through the other side of the glass slab. Okay, I'll tell you what will you find. These are the images when you look from the glass slab of the threads. You will see that these do not lie on the same line as your objects. These are a little shifted, so the position of the images is not same. Now I'll keep one green thread spool to cover those images. Those images should not be seen to you, such that you will place it. Another one brown spool I'm keeping so that I cover the green one as well. So now what has happened? When you look from this side, all the four spools, these two green and brown spools and the image of the red and yellow one, they all line one single line when you look through the this side of the glass slab. Now what is the exact position? I'll show you the actual positioning. You will see that actually these are not in one same line, right? Now what we'll do, I'll mark these two positions where the green and brown one we have placed. So these are the apparent positions of the first two spools, okay, looking through the glass slab. So you get an image like this. Now I'll join these points. So what this exactly becomes, this is how light comes out of your glass slab or emerges out of your glass slab. These two points R and S, so this becomes your emergent ray. This is how it comes out. Now remove the glass slab and thread. Now we'll see what exactly has happened here. Okay, if there was no glass slab, light was supposed to go along this path, isn't it? Like the one that I've shown from a dotted line using a scale. You can do this. So this was the original path, but because of glass slab, what happened? Light did not go through that path, but deviated. So what exactly has happened is, this angle of this incident ray, first it bent towards the normal because it is going from air to glass, rarer to denser. At this point it goes from denser to rarer, so bends away from the normal. and this angle is called the angle of emergence, represented by E. The angle between normal and emergent ray is the angle of emergence, and this is your refractive. Now just measure the angle of emergence and you will see that it comes out to be 30 degrees. So angle of emergence also comes out to be 30 degrees, which is exactly equal to the angle of incidence. So this is your first observation, that angle of incidence is equal to the angle of emergence. So now I have projected this incident ray forward. You will see that the incident ray is parallel to the emergent ray. It means that the light actually does not bend here through a glass slab, means its angle doesn't change, it just shifts little to the side laterally. This distance is called lateral shift or lateral displacement. The distance between the incident ray and emergent ray, the perpendicular distance between them, is called lateral displacement. Now we can repeat this experiment using different incident angles. Okay, for example, you use 60 degrees or 45 degrees or 35 degrees, any angle of your choice, and check if you are getting the same angle as your angle of emergence and a lateral displacement, means parallel lines. If these, so these are the two main observations. First is angle of incidence equal to angle of emergence, and second, incident ray is parallel to the emergent ray, means there is only a lateral displacement of light but no deviation, means there is no change in the angle with the glass slab, with respect to glass slab. This is a very important experiment, friends, for your board exam, and I hope you had fun doing it at home. Even though you cannot attend school or lab, but you can easily do it at home.